So this is an evolution of my 5.1 and stereo downmix template for Resolve. The changes that I've made, obviously we've now got 7.1.2 buses for each individual stem. So we've got dialogue, we've got effects, we've got Foley, ambience, and MX, which is our music or score, and then our master. So those are our now 7.1.2 buses that also crash down to 5.1 and stereo. Now, I know sometimes when you export an ADM, you can choose to export, I know you can in Pro Tools, to export a 5.1 and a stereo version as well, but I've set this up here so that when you go to do deliverables, if you want to, you can select these as separate outputs and send those as well. So there's a few differences between the 7.1.2 Dolby Atmos and the stereo and the 5.1 is we don't have these extra M&E channels and the full effects channels. I'll show you why when we do our deliverables later. But for now, to explain, M&E is just music and effects. It's a deliverable that most companies that you're sending to will want. And that's just a mix down of all the effects and the music without the dialogue. And a full effects here is, this is just an addition that I've made because I've actually got the separate effects, Foley and ambience as separate stems, more for archival purposes. So if you need to remix something, you will have those stems or pre-dubs so that you can bring all that back into your DAW and remix it if you need to. But then you also have the full effects, which is the print of those three as well. So that's just something that I thought would be handy for you guys, specifically for archiving. And if you need to bring up an old mix and you don't have all the plugins and stuff, you can pull in those stems and work with that. Or even send that to like your international mixer who might mix, want to remix it with their dialogue if they're putting in another language. So at the top here, we've got limiters for each, and you've also got some loudness meters, which you can use. And so that's up to you if you want to change those loudness meters, but you can have them open while you're working and mixing as well. But the limiters are just to stop everything going over sort of 0 dB or clipping with your stems and all that sort of stuff. So as an addition to the original 5.1 and 2.0 template, other than changing all the buses, including reverbs to 7.1.2, I've now got objects as well. So you'll see here that I've got my DX channels and there's 12 of them, and I've made it 12 because that's the size of the mix or how many channels you get on their controller. So I thought that would be a great way to split that up. So you've got your standard 12 DX channels and they feed straight to the bed, so the DX bed. But I've also set up four different DX channels here that are objects, and that's so if you want to pan those objects in a different way outside of the bed and give you a bit more, you know, if you want to do voice of God and send it to the ceiling or whatever, you can do that with these object based. And rather than having to change any of these channels to an object based, I've just got it there. So all you do is grab your audio and you put it into that channel, and then you can do whatever you want, whiz it around the room. The other thing that I've had to set up in the routing is you'll see here that the output of these, they'll go straight to the Dolby Atmos renderer, but they also go to the 5.1 and stereo downmix dialogue channels. Now, the reason I've done that is because if you send something to an object to the Dolby Atmos renderer, then that won't go through to the 5.1 and 2.0 downmix because they aren't actually going to these beds, which are then going to the downmix. They're going to an object. I'll show you now how I've patched this through to the renderer. And if you want to make any changes like adding tracks, or you want to change some of those audio tracks to object based, then you can do it through the Fairlight and you go to patch in and out. And if you've got, you can either go to your buses, and you can see here that I've got down here, there's the master bus or bed going to the bed channels here in the renderer. Or if you go to track direct, you can then basically change any of these tracks that you want through to the renderer as an object. You just need to remember that you need to patch those through to the 5.1 and stereo. That's if you want to change anything. So you can see here, I've got the four dialogue tracks or objects. They're going through here to those first four. Then we've got our ADR and they're just patched through. So all the different objects that I've set up for you are already patched through to the renderer. So I'll show you, we've got four channels of DX after the DX. There's four channels of ADR, just in case you want to do that with some ADR. Then we've got After Effects, we've got I've got six mono and then six stereo effects tracks. So again, if you want to put something into an object, rather than changing those channels, it's not like Pro Tools where you can automate it to become an object. So I've just set up those channels. So you just drag the audio file straight into that channel, obviously make sure it's in sync, and then it's an object. So we've got effects. I've even got some Foley ones as well. There's six Foley, which you probably won't use, but I set it up just in case, through to ambiences. Now, with ambiences, just note that if you're going to put something in object, it might be like a dog bark and you want it in a specific spot. So I've got six mono again and then six stereo. But, you know, if you're going to be working with sort of surround ambiences, or maybe you have lots of layers and you want to add maybe some raindrops in the ceiling, or in the heights, I guess you call them, then you can put the raindrops in that channel and then you can move them around into the height speakers. And lastly, we've got 12 stereo music tracks as well that are objects. So if you have some elements in the score that you want to whiz around the room or put it in the heights, you've got those channels as well. Now, you can obviously change these to mono as well if you want to right click, and you can change the track type to mono. If you don't want stereo, or you've got a mono music track, but I think most people mixing scores or working in scores, most of their channels are going to be in stereo. They might have reverbs and things, so you can use those in a stereo format. I've also got an MX or music up mixer, which I did in the original 5.1 template, because you might want to up mix your stereo stuff to 5.1. So you just want to change your output here to be the MX up mixer here, and then that will send it through to the MX up mix channel that's here. And I've currently got the Pentio upmixer, and that'll upmix now to 7.1.2, not just 5.1. So you can send separate stems from the, you know, the stereo stems through to that, and it will upmix it into 7.1.2 as well. Once you've finished your sound edit and your re-recording mix, it's time to send your deliverables. What you need to do is put an in and out point, so you use INO, set your in and out point for your video. We go to Fairlight, Immersive Audio, and Export Master File. Now, you want to export this timeline. This will be your ADM file or your master that has the bed and the objects in it, and we just click export. Once you've exported your ADM file, we need to export all the stems. That's the 5.1 and the stereo stems. We want to go to audio only. You select audio here, and you want to make sure that your settings are correct, your sample rate, your bit depth, and you want to select render one track per channel, and you need to make sure that all your 5.1 and your stereo stems are there on the list. And when you export those, they will all be exported out as separate WAV files, and then you can send those off to whoever needs them or archive them for your own purposes. The one other thing you need to do is an M&E mix for your Dolby Atmos. And what I recommend you doing is just going through, and we're going to mute all our dialogue tracks. So we want to mute our DX, our ADR, and our DX reverb. And now that won't be sending to our master bed, but everything else will be, including our objects. So now that we've muted those, we can go through and just go File, Export, and we want to go Export Master File, and you'll call that M&E. So that is your Dolby Atmos M&E ADM file as well. So once you've done that, you'll have your master ADM, you'll have your M&E ADM, and if they do want stems as well as ADM files, which is possible, and it's probably a smart thing to do, all you do is mute and unmute the group. So, you know, if you want to, you could just mute all the dialogue again, you could mute the MX as well, and then you've got an effects-only ADM file. And then you can mute all those and unmute your MX. And then you now have an MX ADM stem. So you want to obviously go up here and you want to export that master file and change the name. If you purchase my template, you'll be sent a timeline file. If you want to open that up, you just go to Media Pool, we right click, go to Timelines, Import, and you can import the timeline and you'll get exactly what's in front of me. If you want to turn that into a preset, if you go up to Fairlight Preset Library, you want to select here and go down to Fairlight Configuration Presets, and then you want to go Save New. We'll go Create New, and you want to call it whatever you want. You don't have to call it Noisy Post, but we're going to call it that for this demonstration. And then now if you open up a blank timeline, you can just go to this window, you select that and go Apply, and it will add this timeline to any timeline. So you want to do that first before you import your AAF file. So once you've set that up, we've got all our channels ready to go, and then you can import your AFF file, which you can do through this same timeline import, and we go AF, We click that and you can select your AAF and it will import it into this setup here. So that's the changes that I've made to the Dolby Atmos version of this template. Now, I didn't want to make this video long, so if you want to learn more about how to use the template, like sending reverbs and things like that, then I recommend you seeing the original version of the 5.1 and stereo template video, which you can see in the description below. If you've got any questions, please write them in the comments below or reach out to me at my website, noisypost.com.au, and I recommend you going to my website because I have other products, including a Pro Tools template. I've also got practice productions, which help you practice on short films that have already been released, and it gives you a chance to work on your dialogue editing, your sound design and mixing, all in a project that is professionally done. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you on the next one. We'll